Hi everyone, my name is Julia Lee Cunningham and I'm an assistant professor at the Ross School of Business at the University of Michigan. Today I would like to share with you some of my research related to the reflected best self concept and what you can do to incorporate some of these insights into your everyday life, especially during these challenging times. What I mean by reflected best self is essentially understanding how people in your social network recognize and affirm your positive impact on them. There is this fundamental human motivation to feel socially valued and appreciated. My research is about how we can affirm your social worth by actively bringing in other people's narratives about you. Imagine that your close relationships, your family, friends, and coworkers are holding up a mirror for you, and you can see how you are adding value to your social network in this way. Doing this tends to make people realize what they have been missing out, which we call positive blind spots. These are certain behaviors that are picked up by others, but in your mind, you do this naturally because that is just part of who you are. But to others, this particular behavior is something that they remember about you. So when you collect these stories from others that highlight who you are when you are at your best, you realize that you are a valued contributor across many social contexts in your relationship with others. So in this way, reflected best self has important consequences for thriving and human sustainability because it helps people see themselves as a valued contributor. Specifically, my research demonstrated that this reduces both emotional exhaustion and the stress that comes from worrying about being socially excluded, which allows people to be emotionally resilient. Coincidentally, many years ago, I actually conducted an experiment that placed senior executives studying at the Harvard Kennedy School of Government into a crisis situation, so much like what's happening right now because of COVID-19. In fact, it was a crisis simulation about a pandemic that involved a respiratory disease. These executives were put into emergency response teams to come up with the best recommendations for the governor, but we made an important change. Some teams were given something at the very beginning that was slightly different. One group of teams had the opportunity to receive stories of their own best self from their close relationships before this crisis simulation began, whereas the other teams did not have the same opportunity. In this study, we found that the teams that received the stories of their best self from others prior to crisis simulation performed better than the teams that did not. So this research suggests that there is something very special about seeing yourself as a valued contributor. And our follow-up studies found that team members who internalized this identity of being a valued contributor were much more likely to share their unique expertise and perspectives, which ended up helping the teams function better. Although I recognize that most of us are not currently advising governors, all of us can be heroes in small ways to other people. This is particularly true during this current real-world global crisis. My research found that your best self does not have to be your most extraordinary best self because people in your life tend to remember the small things that you do or say every day. So being kind to one another and providing support for those who are in need of help can be part of your best self narratives during this very real and scary pandemic. I think constructing and internalizing this identity as a valued contributor comes in many forms. One thing that you can start doing right now is to collect these best self stories of yourself from others. For example, since I started teaching at the University of Michigan, I have kept all the thank you notes I received from my students. And you may begin by searching your inbox for messages you have received that highlight your unique strengths and contributions. You can print them out and make them accessible so that you can go back to these reminders of your best self whenever you would like. Pay close attention to all the specific ways in which you are making a difference in their lives. Reach out to your social network. People are very open to connection right now that they are stuck in their homes. What are the moments that people tend to remember and cherish? Who are these people who lift you up and energize you? What are the stories that you hear over and over? And what are the patterns of your personal qualities that best capture who you are at your very best? Again, the goal here is to actively use other people's stories as your own resources for thriving. So start today. you will be surprised at how powerful it can be and how it can make you a more effective leader.